Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today in this video we will make some sand dune and desert scene in this video. Let's go to the tutorial. First, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons and after that type Landscape. We will activate it. With the Shift A under the mesh, as you see as a landscape, we will add a terrain in here. From the left menu, under the operator presets, you can choose dune. And with the random seed, you can select your type, how you want to add some noise or random seeds with the different shapes. You can set it all of them from this menu. I will choose this type and after that we will make a material for this. First, under the world, for seeing our textures clearly, we will add a sky texture in here. From there, you can set your sun elevation, sun rotation, air and ozone values. After that, in the object, you can add a sand material in here. First, we will add a bump node and connect your normal to your principal BSDF normal. And you can set up your base color from here. And after that, we will add a noise texture and connect your noise texture effect for the bump height. And pressing Ctrl T, adding your mapping nodes. For this, under the add-ons, you can set up your node wrangler. And with this, under the noise texture scale, you can change it and give a detail, scale and roughness value for your sand material. Now, we will add some wave texture in here. For the mapping nodes vector, connect your wave texture. And after that, as an extra, add mix color. Connect your wave texture effect to A and noise texture effect to B. For the result of the mix color, connect it for the bump height. And mix texture result, connect it to the principal BSDF roughness. As you see, our material will look like that. With this changing your wave scale, you can give some pattern for this. Which shape or which type you want material, you can set it. And mix colors factor, you can set it up your sand material details. And after that, shift it to duplicate your sand materials, or if you want, you can add different landscape under the dune with random seeds. Let's make some columns. For this, we will add a circle for our scene with the mesh. And in tab to edit mode, choose all of with A, E to extrude top, and E to extrude right click and S to scale. With the same pattern method, you can E to extrude, right click, S to scale, and E to extrude it up. We made it before with other scene tutorials. You can check other videos in my YouTube channel. After that, choose middle faces and checker deselect. From the left menu, you can set your deselect and selected value. And E to extrude, right click, and Alt S to scale for this. With the Shift key to duplicate it, if you want, you can add some extra blocks top of your columns, but I will delete it later. Let's add some outer ground parts. You can add a circle again, E to extrude it, and E to extrude right click and S to scale, and continue to making this type. With the F, you can fill it. From the Blender Market, I downloaded this Real Damage add-on. I will use this for my columns. You can use it which shape or which type you want. And from the Polyheaven, I downloaded this Worn Rock Natural Material as a 2K. Now, I will choose my object. I am adding my new material under the shading. You can press Ctrl-Shift-T and choose your textures maps. In tab to edit mode, select all with A, U and Smart UV project. If it's too bumpy for you, you can unconnect your displacement. For the near parts of your sharp edges, you can control B to bevel them. And with the middle mouse button, increase your value. You can control L to link your material, all of it. When you choose your column, with the pressing N, you can see real damage add-on, you can add some damage, and under the modifiers, set up your depth, density, and scale for giving some damage parts of your objects. It will look like that as an ancient type. And you can add them in a collection and place where you want. And shift it to duplicate your other columns, maybe you can fill up your scene with these columns. Let's add some portal. For this, we will add a plane to our scene and scale it. Adding a material as a portal and go to shading tab. We will set something in here. First, we will add a mix shader between principal and material output. After that, you can add an emission node with Shift A and connect your emission to shader 2. Set up your strength and color from here. Now we will add a color ramp. Connect your color ramp's color to mix shader's fac. And with the black node, you can set it up. And with the Voronoi texture, we will connect our distance to color ramp. With the scale, you can set it again. And we will add some noise texture in here. We will connect vector of the Voronoi texture. From here, with the scale, detail, and roughness, you can set your portal type from here. Or with the principal BSDF base color, you can change your color. I will make it black it later, and I will change my Voronoi texture. For the giving some movement for our portal, you can set up your Voronoi texture scale. After that, press I to give some keyframe. Under the timeline, as you see, go to last keyframe. After that, change your scale under the Voronoi texture and press I to set your keyframe again. When you press space and continue to your timeline's keyframes, as you see, it will be move like that. And give some effect like a portal. For making our background opacity, you can choose your color ramp's color and connect your principal BSDF alpha. And as you see, it will become like that. With the emission strength, you can change your color or strength where you want. For the adding fog, we will add a cube for our scene and cover up our ground. From the camera angle, it will look like that. Under the shading, add new fog material, delete your principal BSDF and add principal to volume, connect volume to volume, and set up your density. Add color ramp, connect your color to emission strength, and add noise texture in here, connect fac to your color ramp. With the black node under the color ramp, you can set it up and change your density again. If you want, you can give some color under the principal to volume base color. As you see, our scene will look like that. You can add some extra loop cut for your columns and giving more natural shape for this. And shift it to duplicate some part of it and put them where you want. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.